Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be working on the supercharged Grand Cherokee again, and today we're going to put this intercooler on it. Now, I've kind of already looked at it a little bit, and this is the smallest one I can get that was reasonable in price and in outlets. If I went any smaller, I went to like K-car stuff with tiny inlets and outlets, but this is the smallest core I could find. It's a FB600 brand. I guess the company's called Frostbite. But it's still too wide, but just barely. It's almost gonna make it. Once I get this in here, I think what I'm gonna do, I've got two of these vibrant 90s, tight radius. I think by the time I cut this off, cut that off of there and weld this on, and then on this side, there's no way I'm getting anything in there. It's just not gonna happen, so I think once this is lifted up, I'm going to graft this elbow in just inside of it. Just whatever shape it's got to be to get in there. And I'm going to call that good and then cap off the old end. I might just adapt that because I still got to put another blow-off valve on it somewhere. It has to have one of those. It'll be all right for my test, but I'll have to have one. It helps to recirculate to keep the heat down. Now, how much, I don't know, but I do know when I had this whole drivetrain, the Super Coupe drivetrain that this blower is off of, this is actually the second blower, its diaphragm was bad, so it never recirculated, and it eventually, on a two-hour drive, this thing had 373 gears, but on a two-hour drive, it melted the blower. Like, it got so damn hot. So I don't want to do that again. And the way this is now, I've thought about actually getting a recirculator valve and putting it back into the intake just to help keep water and stuff out. Now, the tube that was on it, this thing is always pushing air out of it. It's never sucking air in. It's always pushing air out. So this is how it stayed pretty clean. If water starts coming at it, it's already pushing air out. When you let off, this thing really spits. So I'm not too worried about doing this, but considering how dirty everything is, it's not a bad idea to actually recirculate it, and just less chance of crap getting in the engine. But this is my first step. I'm going to cut that off, I'm going to weld this on, and we're just going to put a coupler there, kind of mock it up, and see just how this side's going to work. It's not going to be ideal, and it's not going to be perfect. But I think it'll work. But that's what I'm gonna do. This is the situation we're in. This is what I wanna do. I don't wanna go any smaller than that. Now, another thing to consider is this is gonna cover up the oil fill. So you're gonna have to take this off every time to put more oil in it. Or I'll just put another filler somewhere else. It's not a big deal. I got a welder. I just don't have any great ways. Besides, I mean, I could get really creative and buy a core and build ends. I know I could do that. But this is just a cheap project. I'm not that worried about max flow. I mean, this thing makes less than, it probably makes over 200 the flywheel. But, I mean, the most I'm ever going to really care to make is maybe another 30 horsepower. It's to putt around in the woods. It's not a race Jeep. So this is going to be fine for what I'm doing. It's not going to hurt my feelings. Hopefully it doesn't bother too many of you. But I'm gonna get to it.
Good enough for a tag to mock it up.
So far, so good. I don't have anyone to hold this up over here, so I'm just gonna have to eyeball it. But all we gotta do now is get this in there somehow. Can always shorten this some too. By the time that's flat, that can get in right there. If I bring it in. I know at the very least I gotta cut this off right here. Very least. So we're gonna start with that. Alright, I've got it rigged up in here some more. I'm gonna kinda eyeball the shape. And we'll just take chunks at a time until hopefully we don't go too far. Even though we probably still will. It's gonna be a little bit of an angle. More narrow, more angle. We'll start with that, maybe. Too much. We'll start here, and then we'll just start trimming and trimming and trimming until we get it right. First cut. I know it's gonna be way off, but we gotta start somewhere. So we know we gotta cut more that way, and probably another inch down. And that thing's sitting, that'll kind of square itself. We're not looking too bad, just need to get this down. And it not pushing it over. Say we come, I don't want to go too far. It's still wet. All right, but we're gonna go down till it ends. Oh, we're gonna bring this down to here for sure. And this over at least a half an inch this way. We want that little bit of radius there, else it's going to look like we stuck a pipe on it at an angle, and that's kind of what we're doing. I just don't want it to look too bad. Alright, we'll cut it one more again. Here we go, cut number two. This is probably going to be fairly close. Oh yeah. That's pretty decent. We're there. Hell yeah. Now it's gotta trace it and gut that corner. Make sure this is down far enough to really get a bite. I think it's as far as it can go. Shoot, yeah. Now, I know the hood's not going to close without cutting more, but that's okay. Take a look at it. I don't think we have to cut it a lot, just some. If the hood can close, that's a good sign. This means we need to trim. Hell yeah, that's gonna be freaking sweet. That's gonna work out. It's probably touching right here a little bit, which I can cut out, I don't care. Also, since the way this thing's been, also these things are great. Power Probe brand. Comes with a charger, it holds all of them and acts as one big light too. But I've kind of changed my mind on doing, I might still get another hood, but I think I'm gonna cut this back even more wherever it stops to about right there. And then I'll take it to work or maybe make a template, cut a piece of sheet metal out to fill that in to make it part of the scoop to get as much air as possible. Now it's opened over here, which doesn't matter to me. That'll kind of aim some air towards our filter and just act as a vent to help cool everything under the hood. So this is freaking sweet. Looks like I gotta trim this a little bit. We'll be all right. What if I take just this side down? So I'm gonna trim one more time and we'll mark it up. That's gonna do it. It's got us rocked the way we want, I think. Be sitting right there. Shoot, yeah, it's gonna look all right too. And like I said, it's probably not gonna be optimal flow, but it's gonna work. I've got my basic hole made. Now I'm gonna take this grinder. Now it's not the most aggressive thing, but smooth all this out. This shouldn't take too long with this. We're gonna swap over to this in the drill. I don't have my setup right now to slow down the grinder with the aluminum bit, so it gets way too fast and hairy. So I just have to do it with this. That's how I end up bending all this stuff. That takes chunks out. Also to do that and then come back with those. And a long process of cleaning all the crap out of it.
Got it about as good as I can get it. That'll work. I think I've got a piece, 2.5, it's a solid block. I think I'm just gonna throw another coupler on this and plug it off for now for testing. So I'm gonna take it back off later. Well, one, we're gonna test it with the pipe, with the scoop taped off, with the scoop, and then with this in the scoop. But I'm gonna have it back off in a later episode, put the recirculator valve in. I'll have to weld that in on that side. And I don't wanna just put some thin tube in here to try to hammer that into shape. I wanna get something at least as thick as this. So I'll have to order that. So that'll just be capped for now, but it'll work. But time to weld. I think it turned out pretty decent. That's gonna freaking do it. I don't think it looks too bad. Like I said, I'm sure it's not perfect. I know it's not perfect for flow, but given the circumstances, I'm proud of it. It'll work. So I'm gonna take it back off, weld the crap out of it, and then I'll get to try it out tomorrow. I'm not the best welder in the world, but it should hold. Most of it looks like crap. I'm pretty proud of this spot over here. That's pretty decent. I get pretty shaky, so anywhere I can brace my hands up pretty good, I usually do all right. Anywhere I gotta hold it out, I'll start getting shakes. So now it's just gonna cool off and we can put it back on. Well, I think that's gonna wrap it up. I'll do this video tomorrow. I'll just be working on testing everything. But just so you know, this is why you want a recirculation valve. Without the recirculation valve, it's trying to blow that thing apart. So I may have to, what I may have to do is go do all my runs with the pipe, with the scoop closed and then the scoop open. And then I think I'll cut this off and weld it to a short piece of tube to stick in there for now until I get my actual recirculation valve. And then whenever I do that, I'll cut that off and block it off. Try to make it look like it's one piece. Because I think right now, if I try to do it, it's gonna try to blow itself apart. I don't want to do this again. Or whatever, it might hurt. Surely it'd blow a boot off first, but I don't want to do that. So I'll rig something up for the blow off valve tomorrow. That's gonna be it for this video. It's on there. I'll get ready for testing tomorrow. I got some stuff I gotta do in the morning, so probably keep a lookout for Saturday night, maybe Sunday morning. I'll put out that video, hopefully, as long as it's not pouring down rain. I haven't checked the weather. So we'll try to, I'm gonna try to hit the same spots. 111's got some really long hills, so if it's gonna get the hottest on those hills. So I wanna test it on the hills. So we'll do scoop blocked off, run it, scoop unblocked, run it again. I'll come back home, cut the blow off valve off, weld it to a pipe, stick it in there, and we'll do it again. There should be a pretty significant jump between those. I may have to trim the hood a little more. I already closed it once, so it can't be that far off. I might have to trim a little bit. I'll do that off camera because it's just me grinding some crap off the hood. Thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe. We'll keep building stuff.